You have died for me. want to say, I've enjoyed serving and the Holy Spirit is in the midst of this building this day. Hallelujah. We thank God. I'm going to ask y'all to turn with me to the book of Nehemiah, chapter 8, and I'm going to start at verse 8. Amen. We've been in a series of for His glory. Amen. Everything that we do is for the glory of God. And we should start acknowledging, as we learned last week, that God's glory is truly everywhere. So we're in the book of Nehemiah, chapter 8, and I'm going to begin at verse 8 and read. They read from the book of the law of God, making it clear and giving the meaning so that the people could understand what was being read. Then Nehemiah, the governor, and Ezra, the priest, and the scribe, and the Levite, who were instructing the people, said to them all, "This day is sacred to the Lord your God. Do not mourn or weep, for all the people had been weeping as they listened to the words of the law." Verse 10. Nehemiah said, "Go and enjoy choice food and sweet drink, and send some to those who have nothing prepared. This day is sacred to our Lord. Do not grieve, for the joy of the Lord is your strength." Father God, we thank you for a word from you today. Father God, we ask that you will prepare our hearts and our minds to hear unto you, God. Remove anything that would hinder us from getting your word. Holy Spirit, I ask that you will increase in me and that I will decrease in the natural, that your word will go forth in truth, power, and clarity. Give everyone ears to hear and a heart to receive on this morning. In Jesus' name we pray. God's glory is my joy and my strength. Amen. God's glory is my joy and my strength. We've got to own that. Amen. A lot of times when we hear the law and we take a look at ourselves and realize the sinful nature and the people that we are, sometimes we can want to weep and mourn too. Amen. That's what they were saying. Let's go back to verse 8, and I'm going to read through it again. I just want us to get some understanding of this. They read from the book of the law of God, making it clear and giving the meaning so that people could understand what is being read. Amen. So they were gathered around, and they were hearing the law of God. Amen. That had been brought, and He's up on a pedestal so everybody can hear, and they're getting clear understanding. And so it just brought to my memory, as we should be studying the word of God, we should be getting and seeking clear understanding of what the word of God says, because then we're learning the true character and the true nature of God. And so in this moment, I believe that they were hearing, and now they were understanding who God really was, His character. This is the law of my God. This is the type of God that I serve. Verse 9 tells us, then Nehemiah, the governor, Ezra, the priest, and the scribe, and the Levites who were instructing the people, said to them, "This day is sacred to the Lord your God." This is a sacred day. Amen. "Do not mourn or weep, for all the people had been weeping as they listened to the words of the law." Amen. When they heard and they understand, do you know that we get to a point in this walk that the blinders come off our eyes and we start seeing clearly the word of God and clearly understanding what God's character is? And then we start holding up our mirror and looking at ourselves and saying, "Oh God, oh God, I have been a simple person. Oh God, I feel that I'm not worthy." Amen. But God is telling you, "I want you to understand who I am, and I also want you to understand who I see you to to be and who I know you can be if you truly take hold of this word. Amen. And so we shouldn't weep and mourn, but we should rejoice and thank God for the word. Thank God for the clarity of God's word, that we can examine ourselves and we can be honest with ourselves, and then we can declare that I can be all that God has called me to be, because it's not for me, it's going to be for His glory. It's going to be for God's glory, that He can get the praise, that He can get the honor. But I'm worthy to be a participant in that. Amen. And so we've got to continue to look at ourselves. And then just a brief summary of where we are in this chapter. Amen. This story, this is about God's people coming home after a 70-year exile. Amen. Coming to rebuild Jerusalem. And when I thought about us returning after a 70-year exile, I think about our walk and sometimes how we've been on exile. We've walked away and we've turned away and we've been in exile for X amount of years, but now we have a chance to come and rebuild Jerusalem. Now we have a chance to come and participate in the good work. Now we have an opportunity to get things right. Amen. We have to hold on to that, and we have to take time to really say, I want to come back, and now I want to be a part of rebuilding. I've torn down a lot of stuff with my actions, with my words. I did a lot of wrong, and I'm not going to mourn and weep over those things anymore, but now I'm going to take part of rebuilding. Amen. I want to be a part of rebuilding Jerusalem. I want to be a part of rebuilding the kingdom of God. Now I want God to get the glory through my life, and so I want to be a positive example. I want to come back. Amen. Even though I felt that I've been out here on exile all by myself doing things wrong and away from what God had for me, now I'm taking the time and I'm taking the opportunity. I'm answering the calling to return to Jerusalem. Will you return to God? Will you return to the kingdom? Will you now participate in building up the kingdom and being a positive participant in the things that God has called for His people? Amen. And so they were returning after a 70-year exile, rebuilding the wall. Amen. Making a new city again, the temple. Amen. And they wanted to restore the temple. The stage there was set for the returning of Jesus Christ the Messiah. Amen. And so we've got to learn and know that when all of Judah was taken into exile, it was about, they were forced to walk out of ancient Persia and what we now know that to be in southern Iraq and northern Iran. And we still know what's going on over there. So the Bible tells us that there were between 4,600 and 10,000 people that were taken into exile. But while they were away, amen, God expanded the group, amen. Now they're up to about 100,000 to 150,000 people. And so it was a small group out there by themselves, and now they were expanding. They have expanded to 100,000 to 150,000 people. And then, good God Almighty, in 7 years, they got the opportunity and invitation to come back and rebuild your kingdom. Amen. Come on back home and rebuild your city. Amen. Everybody got the invitation. Everybody. Do we got about 150,000 people that came back? No, everybody didn't answer the invitation. They got comfortable with, now I've made, you know, a pretty all right living now, and I ain't worried about going back. And I got from that what God pointed to me, is that we can miss out on seeing the glory of God and being a part of fulfilling His will so that God's glory can be shown. We can get so comfortable with being mediocre and just settling for where we're at that we forgot the promise that God has spoken to us. We forgot the person that God showed us to be, and then we just settle for doing this. But God is saying, I'm giving you an invitation. Now I want you to step it back up. I want you to be a part of something. We got to make sure that we're having ears to hear from God. And when he says, go back and rebuild, that we get on our way and we go back and we rebuild. Amen. And so make sure that we're not missing out, because we learned that God's glory is everywhere, but we can choose not to be a participant in that. We can choose not to take hold of the provisions that God has given us and the opportunities that God has given us. We can choose to ignore those things, and we can say, right, because yeah, I'm making do and things are all right. But when you know, you hear God freaking at your heart and say, I know that you are not going to stay in this place, when you know that I've called you to do X, Y, and Z. Amen. And so we got to stop ignoring that. A lot of times I wanted to ignore you. I'm like, I hear you, God. Now I'm okay now. Just let me stay right here. But God said, oh no. Amen. Make sure that we're answering the call of God. Make sure that we're hearing from God. Amen. And that we're partaking so that we too can see the glory of God, that we can be a part of building up a kingdom. Isn't it awesome that God allows us to be a participant of building up the kingdom? Amen. That he's entrusted us to be a servant. I used to say, thank God for allowing me to be a servant, God. I feel that I'm not worthy, but thank God that I'm a servant to you, God. Thank God that I'm allowed to serve others. Thank God that I can even speak your word, God. Thank you, Lord. It's an honor and a privilege. And so we should be looking at it just that, being anxious to be a part of building the kingdom. Amen. Being a part of the body of Christ so that God can get the glory. Let's make sure that we don't stay out in exile. Amen. Let us come on home and let us rebuild the city. And that starts with us rebuilding our families. Amen. God is saying, I'm going to put you right in your home. Start right there. Start rebuilding your families. Amen. Start telling them about God, but most importantly, start showing them about God. Amen. That they can say, I see what my mama do. I see what my daddy do. I see what my aunt and uncle do. And I want to be a part of that. Start rebuilding brick by brick. And let's start with our own homes. Amen. Because it goes from our own homes, and then our communities start being changed. And then cities will start being changed. And then whole states and whole nations start changing. But it's got to start with our home. Amen. Come on home. Let's rebuild Jerusalem. Amen. Starting in our own home. Glory to God. And so God ain't going to never force us to come on home. But I am telling y'all, you don't want to miss out on this. Amen. Stop ignoring it and come on home. God knows what is the lies ahead of us. And a lot of times we try to figure things out and piece together and say this and that. But let me tell you, when you're walking outside of the will of God, it may go good for a while, but you will never have that peace that you have when you are walking in his will. There is no better feeling than walking in the will of God, because then he is ordering our steps. Amen. He is leading, guiding, and directing. And so when there's a ditch, amen, he's going to direct you around the ditch so you don't have to trip, stumble, and fall and roll. Amen. But that you can pass on by smooth sailing. A lot of times we are walking outside of the will of God, and that's why we get so bumped up and so bruised up and have to go through so many things that God didn't even call us to. Amen. And he said you could avoid that, but you didn't want to come on home. You wanted to stay on out there because you were comfortable. Let us come home, amen, and let us hold on to God's law, amen. Let us rejoice in his law. Let us examine ourselves in his law, knowing that our God is holy, and therefore, yes, the word of God says that we should be holy also, and it's because we want to lift our God up, amen. When we're rebuilding, we want to make sure that our God is lifted up and that our God is honored. And so we can't do that if we are not living a holy life also, seeking to live that holy life, amen. We learn that, no, we're not perfect, as the English language said, but that, yes, we should be maturing, is what the Greek word of perfect means. So each and every day, we should be maturing. And so when we're on exile, when we're outside of the will of God, we should be maturing so that we can take a stand and say, I'm coming back to rebuild. I'm coming back to make things right with God and to make things right with my family and to make things right with the kingdom. Amen. I want to lift up the name of God. I want to give God all the glory, and I'm holding on to, I know that God's glory is going to be my joy and my strength. In chapter verse 10, it says, go and enjoy choice food and sweet drinks, and send some to those who have nothing prepared. The day is sacred to our Lord. Do not grieve, for the joy of the Lord is your strength. Amen. So he's telling them, go and enjoy this choice food and sweet drinks when you return to him. Amen. There's going to be a reward, but don't keep the reward to yourself. Amen. It says, go and give some to those who don't have anything prepared. And so when God starts blessing us and we're returning to him, we need to go out and share a little something with those that don't have anything prepared. Amen. And so stop trying to keep everything to yourself. When God blesses you, when you get it right, go out there and encourage your brother and your sister that may not have it right yet. Amen. Don't forget about them, but go back, because they don't have anything prepared. Now you have something prepared. And so now you are at a point that you didn't have anything to give, but thank God you have something to give now. So let us go back, amen, and share a little something. Let's rebuild the kingdom. Amen. One person at a time, one step at a time. And so we're going to enjoy our choice food and our choice drink. We're going to enjoy the blessings of God. We're going to enjoy the glory of God. And we're acknowledging that glory, but we're not forgetting about those who don't have anything. We're not forgetting about those who haven't returned yet. We're going to be praying those that they're going to return to, that they're going to hear the call of God. And we're not going to give up on them like so many gave up on us. Amen. We're going to go back and we're going to share with our brothers and share with our sister and encourage them. Amen. Encourage them in the Lord. And we're going to declare that this day and every day is sacred. And so I'm not going to grieve. Amen. Because I truly know that the joy of the Lord is our strength. And when I look at this verse in the scripture, I thought about learning that God's glory is everywhere. And then I say, good God, God's glory, that's what's my joy and what's my strength. That's what keeps me covered. That's what keeps me going. Our God is so powerful and so awesome, and he is everywhere. He is with us at all times. He's leading, guiding, and directing. So even in tough times, in trials, I'm saying that's my joy and my strength, holding on to God, not into my circumstances, not into myself, but I'm holding on to God. So we know that for those that do accept the call to come on back home, you're going to enjoy the life that God has called for you, and you will be able to endure through it all. So we know that life can be tough. We can get to a point where we get happy and we say, I've came on back home. I'm on the right track now. But then things appear to start falling apart. Amen. But you have to continue to declare in those moments that, oh God, I'm going to see the glory of God. I know the glory of God is everywhere. I know I've been called on back home. I accepted the call. And I know that the joy of the Lord is my strength. And so I'm declaring that I'm not going to give up. I'm not going to throw in the towel, that I am going to see the glory of God, that I'm acknowledging that he is everywhere. I'm acknowledging that God is in control. And so I'm not going to give up now. Amen. And so We are a work in progress. We are rebuilding. We are working towards something. And so sometimes things don't go according to the plan that we have laid out. But we got to know that God is the architect. He's the engineer. He is the master. Amen. And so he has the master blueprint of it all. And so we should be seeking his blueprint. We should be seeking his will that we can stay on track. And so when it gets rough, when it gets tough, when we are in those moments where we feel like we're on exile and we're outside and we're not accepted on the inside, that we can hold on to God, that we can hold on to his hope, we can hold on to his joy, and we can let that strengthen us. Amen. A lot of times we look for other people to strengthen us, and they're not even strong enough for themselves. So don't get upset when they can't strengthen you. Don't get upset when they can't encourage you. We have to hold on to God and declare, oh, my strength, when I'm feeling weak, I would have to look to the Lord. Amen. When I'm feeling sad, I can still declare that I have joy. Amen. Because the joy of the Lord is my strength. Amen. I see God's glory, so I'm holding on to that. God's glory, I'm taking it a step further. Not only is the joy of the Lord and my strength, God's glory is my joy and my strength. We have to profess and proclaim and speak those things, because we can be feeling like it ain't all good. Amen. And so then that's when we got to stand on the promise. We got to stand on the word, and we got to declare that, oh yeah, it's all good. Amen. It may not look all good or feel all good to you, but the word of God says that it's all good. Amen. The word of God says that, yeah, trials and tribulations, they do come, but I don't have to be worried and I don't have to be troubled about that. Amen. I don't have to give up in defeat. Amen. So we've got to continue to confess that God is good all the time, that we can rejoice, for this is the day that the Lord has made. Each and every day, it's a daily thing to be reminded that God is good, because every day doesn't feel good. And so you have to remind yourself of who God is. That's why I love how they were reading and hearing and understanding about the word of God. And so we've got to read, we've got to hear, and we've got to understand the word of God so we can understand clearly who God is. And so when we need him, we have him on the inside. We can hold on to him, and we can automatically pick up when, oh, I know this ain't the character of God. I know that my God didn't operate in defeat, and my God didn't operate in fear, and those things don't come from God. Amen. And so then we start speaking the truth and believing the truth, that we're not swayed to and fro based on our feelings, our humanly feelings. Amen. Because we are spiritual beings, and so we've got to make sure that we are connecting and having our relationship with God. Amen. That's the only way that we're truly going to see his glory, because in the natural, we may not see, we may miss out when it's so clear. So we've got to make sure that we are connecting with God on a personal basis. Amen. I can't do it for you, and you can't do it for me, but I can return and encourage you to return praying that you will get it one day. Amen. So we ain't gonna give up, even when it gets tough on us, all right? Declare that we returning. Amen. We ain't there yet. Declare on the day, I'm returning. Amen. I'm returning on the day. I may not be there, but I'm returning. I'm coming on back home. Amen. I'm coming into what God has called me to be. We can be excited about it when nobody else is excited, because when you hear God speak to you and give you an assignment, you can be encouraged by that. Amen. You can take hold of that, and you can really let that be your strength of the word of God. Amen. Let that give everything you have to that, doing what God calls you to be, not what people calls you to be. So let's get excited about returning to God. Amen. Let's get excited about reaching back and get somebody else. Let's get excited about that. But we've got to have joy. We can't be living life of defeat and really doubting God. We're like, well, God ain't as good. Ain't no me see you talking about you don't return, but you looking all sad and all you talk about is defeat and what's wrong. We got to start talking and praising God, amen, even during the trials and tribulations, even during the low period of our life. Let's give God the glory. Let's lift him up at all times. So we truly have got to let God's glory and the joy of the Lord be our strength. Not strength from people anymore. Not strength from people's words anymore. But strength from our Lord. Strength from the word of our God. Strength from the promises of God. Strength from the truth. I don't have to receive the lies anymore, because now I'm strengthened by the truth. I've got understanding. I've got revelation. I've examined myself. I'm weak, but now I've dried my tears, and I've declared that today is a sacred day. I've declared that I will have joy in today, so we can return and we can continue to lift God up, continue to honor God, continue to go back and get someone else so that they too may come to know God for themselves. Amen. So we got to make sure that we don't get too about us. A lot of times we get hurt and then we say, you know what? I'm done with people. I'm done with giving people a chance. But God is saying, how many chances did I give you? Amen. You know, how many times did you get on your knees slobbing and crying and say you won't do it again? And then as soon as everything starts going good, you'll be right back into the same old thing. So we got to learn patience. Amen. Because we know that God is love. And one of the attributes of love is patience. Amen. Compassion. We've got to have that. Amen. And so that's a part of us drawing people back. Drawing people to want to know God. Compassion, patience, love, the character of God. God is love. Therefore, let's show a little love. Amen. Let's start giving love on people so quickly. Amen. Because I believe that's a part of God getting glory. When we show compassion, when we show love, when we show encouragement, when we're able to speak a word, even when we're going through, when we're able to return from our wicked ways and go back into what God has called for us, and then lift God's name up, we are giving him the glory. We are really honoring God with those things. And so let us take that into practice with each and every day of our life. So we've got to practice that. We've been doing things so long the same old way, and a lot of times our habit and our routines doesn't line up with the word of God. And so let us get out of routine. Let us examine ourselves and let us make sure that we're in the will of God and that we're operating according to the word of God and that we're seeking God for understanding, revelation, and knowledge. I just love that part. I was like, man, I want to get as much revelation, knowledge, and understanding of the word for myself. It's okay for me to tell it to you. It's okay for you to hear from me or Pastor Jones and Minister Anthony, our deacons and our brothers and sisters, but it's nothing like getting that word and that understanding for yourself. God speaks to us all individually. Amen. And so you've got to get in that word so you can declare that God's glory is my joy and my strength, because you'll know for yourself what God is saying. Amen. It ain't because somebody told you about it. It's because you know about it. Amen. Say, ain't nobody got to tell me about God. I know about God. Amen. Let me tell you who he is. And so we start lifting up the word of God, even in our downtime, even when backs have been turned, that we're not going to keep our back turned on others. Amen. Even when we've been hurt, we've got to get out of that place of hurt, because God is a restorer. So let him restore us. Amen. Get back on track with God. And I'm telling you, he will mend broken hearts. Amen. He will line you up into where you need to go. So don't give up. Don't quit. Keep on glorifying God. Don't forget about those who haven't arrived yet. Back to Jerusalem. Amen. Let us go back and get our brothers and sisters. Let us keep encouraging our brothers and sisters so that they may too come to know God for themselves. Don't miss out on seeing and being a part of the glory of God because you won't partake. Amen. Let us all be partakers. Let us give God some glory by honoring Him each and every day with our lives. Amen. And start practicing the things of God. Start embracing the glory of God. Start practicing joy. We've got to embrace all of these things that God has given to us. We've got to take every opportunity that God gives us. Just like everyone received the invitation to come on back. After your 7 years, it's out. Come on back. Everybody got the invitation. But everybody didn't take it. We've got to make sure that we are taking that invitation. Don't stay in exile. Don't get comfortable out there. Come on back home and be a part of something good. Amen. People may say, you ain't never been about nothing. You ain't never partaking in something good. Well, I'm partaking in it now. Amen. I'm starting today. So I ain't worried about yesterday. I'm coming back today. Let us come back today. A lot of times we get discouraged because we always think about the past and what I didn't do. And like these people, they were hearing the word of God and then they start realizing, man, this is the character of God. And they start weeping. But we've got to rejoice and say, this is a sacred day. I've got understanding. I've got knowledge now. It's going to be a sacred day. I am able to come back, to lift my head up, to partake in the blessings of God, to declare that this year I'm going to see God's glory, to declare that God's glory is truly everywhere and mean it and know it. Amen. Not because somebody told you, but because you know it for yourself. So remember, when it gets tough, don't give up. Hold on to God for your strength. Know that He is everywhere and that He is with us. Amen. If you haven't returned, come on back now. Come on back today. Let God's glory and the joy of the Lord be your strength. Be encouraged each and every day. When I'm not able to encourage someone else, we got to do like David did. Encourage your own self. Amen. Sometimes that's what it takes because we stop getting mad with people. Like I said, a lot of times they ain't even able to encourage themselves. So we know they may not be able to encourage you on a certain day or a certain time. Yes, they may say the wrong thing to you, but you've got to hold on to God, not to people. So let's return to God, let us lift God up, and let us give Him the glory at all times. Is that all right, y'all? Amen. Let's give God a hand clap of praise. Hallelujah. God is truly a good God. Amen. He has sent His Son, Jesus Christ, that I have the victory through Him now too. Amen. That I can be a part of this thing. So let us come back to God. Let us start lifting God up so that it can be for His glory each and every day of our lives. No longer on our own agenda, but that we're seeking God first and foremost in every day. Amen. So we're out of exile. Amen. All y'all want to come on back and rebuild. Let us rebuild together. Let us encourage one another. Amen. So let's just give God a hand clap of praise. For this day is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I just thank God for another opportunity to be in the number. And I want y'all to know, if you are in exile still, if you haven't returned to Christ, I want to give that invitation right here and right now. Before alcohol, before anything, if you don't know Him, if you're still outside, come on back in on this day. If there is one that does not know Christ, I believe God is telling you to come on home in this moment.